Hello friends, I am Sayukta and today we are going to be learning another Zentangle original pattern and the name of the pattern is Huggins. Yes, the name comes from the Huggins family, that is Martha Huggins, that is Martha's husband's family. Yes, the pattern bears its roots in the Huggins family. So Huggins is a sort of a grid-based pattern, start just like the pattern Cadent. Shares many similarities with the pattern Cadent. Let us see how do we draw the pattern Huggins, right? So if you wish for reference, you can draw a pencil grid, but it will not be required because it is easy to draw the orbs without this reference also. It's not much of a hassle. But just for reference, if you wish to start with, if you are a new or a beginner and you're learning the pattern the first time, then it would be good to draw a pencil grid just for reference, right? And then we start with these orbs just like we draw in the pattern Cadent, right? So I'm drawing this series of orbs evenly spaced out, just like squares, four corners of a square, right? This pencil grid I have drawn just for reference. You can always, if you don't need this grid, you can draw this orb straight away, right away, right? And then we start with this C shape. Difference between Cadent and Huggins is, in Cadent you were joining the orbs with the S shape, whereas in Huggins we will be using the C shape, right? But again, the same technique of takeoff from one of the orbs. I am retracing a part of this orb and then taking off and then landing on the second one, right? So once you have drawn the first C shape, also it can be said as an open parenthesis, right? An open bracket. The next one in this column would be alternating, right? So if this is an open parenthesis, the next one would be a closed parenthesis. Why? Because the lines would never be crossing each other. For example, if you draw this shape this way, the second one, if you draw in the same way, they will be crossing each other here, which is not the way Huggins is drawn, right? So if it is landing this side, it will take off from the other side and the next one will be alternating the first one, right? Again, down this column, the third one will be taking off from this side and then landing here, right? So if you are moving from top to bottom, they will be alternating each other. Open parenthesis, close parenthesis, again open parenthesis. Now we move on to the next column. In the next column, these two orbs will be joined by a mirror image of the one opposite to it, right? So it will be like this. Again, a C stroke taking off from this and landing on the second one. A mirror image of this C stroke. So if you stand in front of a mirror and draw this on a piece of paper or on your hand and then put it like this in front of the mirror, then this will be how it will be looking like, right? So if this is an open parenthesis, the second one, the second column, will be starting with a closed parenthesis, which is a mirror image of the first one. Again, once you have the first one, the second is again alternate and the third is again alternate, right? Now we can rotate it like this, right? So first one is again, we will join by a C shape. Since we do not want to cross these lines, it can never be like this, because if we draw like this, it will cross this line. So it has to be like this, right? Once you have drawn like this, the second one facing it would be a mirror image, so it will be a open parenthesis. The third one will be again a mirror image, so it will be a closed parenthesis. The fourth one again will be a mirror image, so it will be an open parenthesis, right? That's how the pattern Huggins is drawn, right? So again, we start with this one, right? So if you consider this as a column now, right, this is an open parenthesis. The next one will be alternate, it will be a closed parenthesis. Again, the next one will be an alternate, it will be an open parenthesis, right? Now we move down opposite, this will be a mirror image, so it will be an open parenthesis. Again, moving down, either you can mirror this one or you can simply alternate, right? So we have learned two concepts here. First is same as cadent, the concept of taking off and landing on the second off using the C stroke, unlike cadent where we use the S stroke. And the second is the concept of alternate and mirror. When you are moving down the column, you are alternating the brackets, and when you are moving to the second column, you are mirroring them. The first one, if you get it right, you just have to keep alternating it, right? And then rotate your tile and do the same thing this way and this way, right? So now these two offs will be a mirror image, so it will be a closed parenthesis. So the checkpoint is the lines can never cross each other. The moment they are crossing each other means you have committed a mistake, right? Again, alternate this, right? Again, mirror image of this will be open parenthesis, mirror image of this would be a closed parenthesis, mirror image of this will be an open parenthesis. So that's how you draw the pattern Huggins, right? So let's do a puzzle. I am going to be drawing a few orbs here, right? And just in between, I am going to draw one C shape joining two orbs. Now from here, how do we take it forward? Let us consider this column, right? So this will be alternate and this will again be alternate. You may see if you try to draw from this side, you will be crossing this line, right? It is taking off from here. You can land on the other side, you cannot cross it, right? Again, if we take up this column, this will be a mirror image, so it will be an open parenthesis. Once you have the first one, just keep alternating like this. Again, this one will be a mirror image, so like this, a closed parenthesis. Once you have got one, just alternate it, right? Again, this one will be a mirror image, so here it will be an open parenthesis, closed parenthesis, and again an open parenthesis. Now you can rotate your tile, or if you want to do it this way only, right? So just connect these two. If you try to connect it this way, you will cross the lines, so line has to be this way. Then again mirror it, so it will be an open parenthesis, this will be a closed parenthesis, again an open parenthesis, right? So these are mirror images. Again, if you draw it this way, you will cross it here, so it has to be an open parenthesis, then close parenthesis, then again open, and then close, right? Again, you have to draw it this way, then mirror it, so open parenthesis, mirror it, then close parenthesis, mirror it, open parenthesis. So that's how we have completed the Huggins puzzle, right? So the tangle pattern Huggins is again open to many tangliations. The space that you see inside here, right, you can use it in a number of ways. There are a plethora of tangles that you know by now. Use those tangles inside Huggins and just you will see how it looks, how decorated it looks, right? The second thing is crazy Huggins. When Huggins, again, when you forget about the grid, the square grid in which you have placed the orbs, you forget about the grid and the Huggins just wants to move in just about any direction, then it is called crazy Huggins, right? Just to show you an example, we draw four orbs, right, and we connect it I have just started randomly, right? And then I draw four more and then just connect them. So this Huggins does not wish to be bound by a grid, right? So you can vary the size of the orbs also, some big, some small, and just go crazy, right? So again, this Huggins, if it does not wish to be bound by the grid, goes crazy, and that's how we draw crazy Huggins, right? So we forget about the grid and just move about in any directions. So just a quick recap. Generally, the pattern Huggins traditionally is drawn in a somewhat square grid using orbs, right? Equally spaced out generally. And then we, using the takeoff and landing technique, we join these orbs using the alternate and mirror technique, right? So these orbs also, they are joined by the C stroke. And if you run down a column, they are alternating C strokes. And if you move to the next column, then they are the mirror images of the first column, right? So the technique of mirroring and alternating is used to complete the grid of Huggins. In the next class, we'll draw a tile using the pattern Huggins, and we'll also learn about crazy Huggins, right? Till then, have a good time, and I'll see you again in part 2 of Huggins.